I apologize because we have some problems with Linux, so some things will not working. Yeah. I'm a mechanical engineer, so I present you some snap systems to Blender that we have discussed in a task on Blender. So this is a patch applied to Blender, and it's not in master, but maybe sometime I hope will be included.
Yeah, I'm an architect. I'm using Blender for architectural visualizations, and want to develop some tools and make Blender easier to use for more technical stuff. Of course, not ruining artistic thing, but to make it more suitable for architects, engineers to work.
So I start with my presentation?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't understand anything. Firefox.
You are trying to display some
Firefox. Not inside Firefox. So
maybe you can press that icon at the top next to that colorful palette. Okay.
Here. This. Here. Oh, no, this is Escape.
Yes, this one. Yeah.
No, I need Firefox. Well, as well.
So Firefox is already here.
Okay.
Okay. Press that one. Oh yeah.
Okay.
Nice.
So. Not so good. So. Maybe this
so
one.
Firefox is also right there at, on the left, the second button.
This one?
This one.
Okay, this is better. Okay. So, as I said, then this is a manual started and pivot points. So, excuse me. The project I'm presenting here is part of a biggest project trying to give Blender more. Utilities to technical people, not only artists, because I think that most of things can be done easily than in Blender nowadays. So the first part of this project will be specifying base points or reference points to allow user set exact references to an object. So we add what's called manual snap targets that allow this. I'll try to start the Blender application. I don't know if it will be possible, I hope. So it's not working. So because I cannot run Blender as itself, because it's a patch applied to Blender. It was working on my laptop, but as what compiled for my system, it's not working here. So sorry about this.
Maybe you can show the video.
Yeah, but there is also no internet. So.
So. The video of this working patch is in the presentation sector in Blender conference. You can go in on our presentation description, and there is video of showing how this patch works. So.
So you select the manual setting. So you first select a point on the object, point references, and then you can place on other objects or same objects. It's done over the wall manipulator transforming code, so it should work in all areas of Blender, in rotations, scales, and also grab.
I can demonstrate. Now in Blender, you have an object, and you press G, grab, move, and you move whole object. precisely. So what we done, that you select object, you press the exact point on edge, and move that point exact to another point in area. So, and it's done with our patch in very easily. It is possible to do in Blender now, but it's takes 5 or more steps to do. So
you can also set references on an edge or on a face, not only vertices. Also works with edit mode. Okay. The next part is our manual pivot points that is similar to center of a transformation. This means that when you go and rotate an object, you can select the center of the rotation. Okay, this is allows you to select these centers, and also in scale the same. You can select the center of the scale. This can be combined with the reference points already shown, because you can first select the center of rotation and just use a point for a reference. So move from one point to another point. And this is only with it's easy to do. Now in Blender it's really hard to make things well aligned. Another feature that has been included here is repeating operators, but not as Blender does, because the repeat operator in Blender repeats exactly the same thing you have done. So the idea of this is that it works, and you do an operation, and then for example a duplicate operation, you duplicate one object, and you can repeat with only placing the object. Placing more objects as the element of object you want. So, and also this can be used to rotate and all this. So these features are focused to make things more easy and more fast, because in Blender nowadays it's really tedious to do some of these kinds of operations. No, it's not an array, because you create a new object each time. Okay. So you play, you make an operation, and then the same operation, you create a new object in another place, and you can use with the snap and center to place, let's say, one object in this vertex, in the other, and really fast, because it's just placing. Yeah, but this is not the same, because it does not give input to the user. You do the same another time. Yes. So the idea is use the reference to just clicking place. It's not the same.
Yeah. So this project was for the Blender itself, modification of Blender itself. Also, we're preparing another add-on. Another it's add-on. All features not working now, because our developer decided to go to vacation and joined the Lithuanian army. So he will return in some months and finish it. But also there is a link in on the Blender add-on in the Blender wiki page where all add-ons is. You can try these features, but not everything is finished, but I can show what this add-on should do. So basically, it is enhancements of custom properties. For instance, when architects or has some object, for instance, we have a table, and we want to do not many tables, but one to one table then add parameters like height, width, and by changing these parameters, transform that table, but precisely. For instance, so you have different types of table, like one smaller, one bigger, one with four legs or with five legs or something. So we created the add-on for making these assemblies. So so we made this assembly editor and assembly selector. So how it works? So firstly, we have a bunch of Blender objects. And then select that object and create the assembly from that object. And then it's the assembly is created. And then we add our custom parameters. So it's basically like custom properties, but managed in more also more in different way. So we add our custom parameters like width of chair, depth, and height. And then we can assign these our custom parameters to the objects in a Blender, for instance, for the seat or for the height, and then had with having while having one model, one chair model, we can change these parameters and have multiple types of the chair. Or it could be window, for instance. We have one model of window, but by changing parameters, we can have multiple varieties of window. For instance, bigger, smaller, with one tile or more tiles. So basically, we will create some like a more smarter object, and without needing to remodel things. So basically, we create these types, and then we can select these types, and then change. For instance, we have this smaller chair, and we change the type, and we have a bigger chair. So basically, that's it. And who is interested in that? Of course, after this talk, you can. Go and finally we can show you on our working laptop how it works and without these technical difficulties. So thanks.